You got that going. Hello, everybody, and thank you very much for making it to another meeting at the Santa Barbara Real Estate Investor Association. We made it in the last 5 months. Yay, we're here. And we had our last meeting, and I said we wouldn't be back for 5 months. I thought, man, what am I going to do for 5 months? And then we quit, let me tell you. But one of the things that I did do for 5 months was business, and we learned a lot of what to do, what not to do in the areas that we're currently working. And as we expand the areas that we're not, we'll learn that as we go too. And we'll come back in here to pass that information on to you. This is our website, Santa Barbara RIA, short version. We are here in the Fess Parker Fiesta Room with a beautiful view out there. So if you get tired of listening to me and want to take a walk, that's okay, I understand. I guarantee you, you're not gonna probably miss a lot or learn a lot no matter what thing you go to, because there is just so much to doing any part of real estate. You really need to do it to learn, okay? So if you walk out of here and go, wow, they just didn't tell me what I needed to know, I don't feel like I got anything, that's okay, because it's going to take a lot more than what anybody's going to tell you. And another reason why I think I said I do this for free, as far as training is concerned, because I know how difficult it is. I know how much time it takes. And I want people to be able to say, hey, Dan, I'll work with you. And then I don't hear from them for 3 months, and they go, well, I got really busy, now I'm going to come back and work with you again. But sure, whatever. It's pretty hard to complain about how well I'm serving you if you're not paying me, right? But I'm there. I'm here. You know, and I'm surprised at how few people do get back to me, but I'm here. Okay? I know it's tough. So that's the website. This is the YouTube, and we've got plenty of stuff up there on YouTube. We have Linda Pliagas here. Yay! She does 411. I'm going to get you up here. And we had a media and expo back in June. And we've got Linda here, and my daughter was interviewing, and my son was here, and my wife Maria's out there doing the registration, and Michael's girlfriend Monica's out there. Michael and his girlfriend Monica. Now we're both working at Best Buy. Yeah. And so we've got tech support. I've been doing computer work for a long time. And if you want to see how long he's been doing computer work, I've got a picture of him sitting at the computer when he was 3 years old. There's his credibility, you know. This guy knows the stuff, so now he's going to be there. And sure, it's great to do what Dad's doing, but guess what? Dad worked for 37 years at a job, too. You have to be able to feed this dream of real estate slowly in whatever fashion you can to the point where you can maybe do it full time. But you can't just quit and think, well, if I make this or if I make that, because you're not going to make it on an if. You've got to prove it to yourself, okay? So everything we do goes up on YouTube. Meetup.com, that's a great place for you guys to be signing up on. It's free. This is what's going to help your networking, get you in contact with each other. You get to show people what you're looking for, and you get to show people what you have to offer, and you guys make a connection. It's a great thing to do. It's all free. Okay. This is the break area. Now, if our break area looked like this, I promise you, you would be paying $100 per seat. $510 for 6 gallons of coffee. We're looking at other places to go. We'll talk about that, too. Okay, so I'm going to cover a few things here. I've got Linda, I've got that Marlon is here, okay? And I've got Rich is back there, okay? We've got some things that I'll be covering here. And then we'll get into Lance Edwards and his brother Brian. And Brian, this is your picture, right?
This is me.
Yeah, okay, I found you out there on the internet, and I grabbed all this information and tossed it on there.
Oh, okay.
Okay. That's why I could recognize you when you walked through the door. Okay. So we'll do that.
I'm wearing the same coat.
Wow. I've had that happen. I can't remember where I was, but I showed somebody my ID, and they said, I see you're wearing the same thing. And I said, this is all I've got.
The closet full of white shirts and a blue coat.
Yeah. So you can see how fun this is going to be. This will be good. And then we're done at the end. We do have a free table back in the corner there. that's got stuff on it. So anything that you want there is free. If there is CDs, DVDs, whatever for training, you can pick it up, you can take it home, you're not stealing. Michael, what, do you not leave back there?
Yeah, don't leave your keys or your cell phone or nothing like that back there. It's a free table, so.
There's also a validation machine. That thing right here?
Right here.
Good. Okay, so if you're parking and you don't want to have to pay $50 for parking, then you need to validate that before you go to there. So we're going to start off here. I'm going to bring up Linda Piagas. And she is, this Linda Piagas runs 411 Realty. She's fantastic. Let's give her a hand.
Hi, everyone. I just want to thank you for joining us today. Dan does a great job. Let's give him a big hand. You know, I attend real estate groups around the country, and I can honestly say that coming here is the greatest joy for me. Because of Dan and Michael, his family, they're just awesome people. And they truly have a desire, a genuine desire to have every one of you succeed. And that's why they do this and they share their knowledge. It goes along with the same line as to why we publish our publication and make it available absolutely for free online. People around the world can download it at any time, day or night. Now we have 5 websites and we're continually growing and expanding and building new websites and buying new domains. We also have events around the country. I'll be in Las Vegas next month. For any of you who'd like to join me, I am driving. You can carpool with me. We'll have a great time. And we're going to be hosting that event with a few groups out there. So I'm very well connected with groups across the country. And it's just a pleasure to do this and to be involved with the real estate investing industry. So thank you so much again. And we have free magazines for everyone right here at the table. Thank
now,
you, Dan.
Before you sit down, I just want to say, Linda is incredible. I don't know anybody in my life that could run around the nation like she does. It put like 2 or 3 of these on for a month. I can't, this like 5 months later on Google, you know? She's doing 3 a month or whatever. It's incredible. And the things that she puts on are big, a lot more people, maybe 200 sometimes, 3. I've been to some where I came back and actually met a private lender that bailed us out of major problems. And, you know, we borrowed how much? $100,000, whatever. But in any case, you might not meet the people you want to at these meetings because they're so small, or you might. But you definitely want to go to her meetings that are much bigger around places she's talking about, especially in Vegas. Imagine going to Vegas.
They're a lot of fun. They really are. And I also met one of my personal private lenders at one of my own events too, who's a different private lender than the one Dan utilized. So it's great. Networking really builds your connections and you can really benefit from it. I know that I profited from that deal and I know Dan was, you know, very thankful for that connection as well. So networking really works. I encourage you to do more of it.
Thank
you.
So
well.
Great to have that support with Linda and all that she does. You know, she's really the person that kind of, she doesn't realize it, but she did kick me in the butt just by example for me to get out of the pizza parlor and get to a nicer place and then get out of downstairs and come up and take this room over and be able to do this. So thank you so much for being my inspiration.
What an honor. Thank you.
And then we have Marlon McKinney.
Thank you so much. Okay, perfect. All right. Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
The visitors are a little sleepy, or good afternoon, or like you say, good evening. You guys are looking forward to sleep tonight. I'm excited to be here today. Let me ask you a question. How many of you guys are excited that you got to wake up today? Only a few of you people, and most of you guys are not excited at all, right? I always say this. How many people thought they're going to wake up today and didn't? There's a lot. There's thousands, right? They died. It's true. I had a friend of mine, 56 years old, a couple weeks ago. We sat, Starbucks just like this. We were talking about finances and things like that. The next day, he had a stroke. 3 days later, he died. Right? He was challenged and stressed financially. Then I had another friend who was making about $70,000 a month in her 40s, right? I don't know exactly when she passed away back in December. You know, making a lot of money, and she died. It might have been of cancer, things like that. When I look at those things, especially those types of friends that were close to me, like, I don't take it for granted about life. Every day I wake up, I say, thank God for another day. That we can be together like this. We're feeling good. We get to network. Like Linda, it was Linda, right? You were talking about that, right? You know, it's all about relationships, right? All about relationships. So what I'm going to talk about today, for those of you guys who don't know, it's my first time here. Thanks to Cynthia Shelton for having invited me to this networking meeting, and Dan having me come up and speak today. My name is Marlon McKinney. I'm from the San Fernando Valley, and my company is called CreditWeRestore.com. And what we do is we help people with less than perfect credit. How many of you guys know anybody who has less than perfect credit? Right? 1 in 3 people have bad credit. And so what we do is we do the credit restoration part of it. So when people have negative items like tax liens and judgments and foreclosures and lates and inquiries and a bunch of different addresses, we get everything cleaned up in about 90 days or less. So their FICO score can go up above 700. And those of you guys who are real estate agents in here, right, as long as your clients have the income to back it up, can sell them houses without a challenge, right? We also do corporations. How many of you guys know anybody who needs to be incorporated? If you're your own business owner, you're not incorporated, you need to do it like yesterday, right? And one of the things that most people don't know about is one of the fastest ways to build credit beyond your personal credit is to be incorporated. So if you have challenged credit and you want a fresh start, get incorporated. It's totally separate from you, right? So we do corporations, business credit, corporate credit, access to funding, and credit restoration. One of the things you'll hear me say is it's better to have more money. How many of you guys would agree it's better to have more money than less of it? Yeah. Anyone that like to have more money, right? It's better to have more money and more credit and not need it than less money and less credit and need more, right? And I say this humbly. I've been doing credit restoration, business credit, since about 2002 for the last 15 years. I built a little over more than $2 million in credit, right? I don't use it all, but I'm ready for opportunity, right? What you're looking at here, just to get a little visual, this is about 106 credit cards, right? Personal and business, a little over $1 million in credit. How many guys can use that and you're ready for opportunity to, you know, maybe get a property and fix up property and things like that? I always say is, why would you use your own money when you can use somebody else's? All the wealthy people do it all day long. Use other people's money, OPM, other people's money. And so I teach this, and it surprises me of how many people do not use other people's money. They go to their savings, their IRA, their 401k, their equity in their home. And if that deal doesn't go right, now you're losing what? Your home, your savings that you have, right? So what we teach is we sit down and we educate. And what you're going to get here today, and I only have a few more minutes, is just a little education when it comes to business credit and credit restoration, right? Because I'm sure you guys are obviously going out there, you're looking for people to buy homes. They have to have good credit. Some of you guys are investors. You want to actually invest in property. I've been investing since 2000. I got into it when you used to buy, remember those HUD properties? You used to bring $2,000 cashier's checks to auctions. There was like 1,000 people, and you'd raise up your card, right, to get properties. Now, if I knew what I knew back from 2006, remember 2006? Yeah. Right, properties were at the height, right? But if I knew what I knew then when we bought them back in 2000, we would have held all the way to 2006. We just flipped them right away to make a quick $20,000, $30,000 profit and move on. But we got properties for like 27,000 one-bedroom condos in Mission Hills that were 300-something thousand dollars at the peak of 2006. Then everybody started to buy, and then what happened? It cut in half. Houses went in foreclosures, cars got repossessed, people had bad credit. But the good thing about it is that you can never not have enough. Let me say that again. You can never not have enough. How many of you guys ever been to a party and they ran out of drinks? Or they ran out of food? I say the same thing at a party. It's better to have more drinks and more food and not need it than to have less drinks and less food and need more. Otherwise, we're going to have to send people out to Costco. True or not true?
True.
Right?
True.
How many of you guys are building credit for yourself right now? How many of you guys got good credit score? You're over 700. You got access to thousands of dollars. How many of you guys are actually utilizing it? Right? Let me tell you a little story real quick. I got a credit card, $15,000 from a credit union. 0% for 12 months. How many guys like 0% for 12 months?
Yeah.
And then usually when you cash advance a credit card, do they not charge you 3% plus a high interest rate? Well, this particular bank allowed you, because they were the ones funding it, They allowed you to take that $15,000 credit card, put it into your bank at no charge. How many guys like that?
Yeah.
Then what I did is I have a friend of mine who owns a car dealership. He says, I have a 2000 Volvo XC90, Ford automatic, fully loaded. It's worth about $7,500. I can give it to you for $4,000. I said, no problem, I'll take it. So I took the money from the credit card that had 0%, didn't charge me anything. I bought the car for $4,500. I sold it a week later for $7,000. How many guys like making a $2,500 profit and you never even touched your money? You use other people's money, right? So we want to put more of this away, right? And keep on using the credit to get more money. So I get excited and passionate when I talk about this because here is the Ventura County heading to Santa Barbara. Is that what's considered the whole Ventura County of things? But a lot of people, how many guys ever saw the show Shark Tank? Right, you see these people lining up and they have businesses. You see Mark Cuban and Lori and all that stuff there. How many guys would like to be your own Shark Tank? See, this is what I think about. What about if we got 10 people, very conservative, and in the next 6 months or less, we build them up $100,000 in credit? Right? Anybody like the 0% for 12 months, right? $100,000 times 12, 10 people is how much? $1 million. Now we have these networking meetings and people are finding properties and wanting to buy properties and there's equity. Now all of us who have credit or access to money can sit there, we can listen to the person, and they say, yeah, there's this property, it's about $400,000, maybe needs $50,000 to fix up. When everything's said and done, we can get about $675,000 for it. So there's more than $100,000 extra. How many of us can say, okay, I'm in, right? And if we didn't have enough as an individual, could we not come together and do it? Yeah. Right? See, I look at credit in a different way. If everybody had good credit, there's a lot more things we all can do. Right? Because credit will generate money as long as you invest it and do the right thing with it. Right? Because most people, when it comes to credit, they get a little edgy sometimes, don't they? You know why they get a little edgy sometimes? They don't want to get in debt because they become consumers. How many of you guys know what a consumer is? They consume everything, right? They'll put it on the credit card. They'll make the minimum payment. They'll end up paying interest rates, even if they have 0%, because they never pay off in full. And so they never seem like to get out of the situation because it's all interest that they're paying. What we teach is make money with the money. In other words, if there's an opportunity to make money with it, that's what you want to do. And so we have a little table over here, my assistant Lucy. I have a giveaway. I always believe the more you give, the more you get. How many of you guys would agree? And so you guys are all going to get a gift today, right? So at the end, if you come to Lucy, I have a book called Business Credit Decoded. This will teach you all the things about business credit, access to funding, and it's my gift to you guys. All you got to do is go there. She'll give it to you. We usually sell for $29.95. It's yours for free. We also have DVDs. How many of you guys ever saw The Secret? You ever seen that? We have a DVD. It's called Predictable Wealth, The Science of Getting Rich, right? Bob Proctor's in it. Les Brown, you ever heard of these type of speakers before?
Yeah.
You guys get to have that for free as well. All you got to do is see Lucy for it. Okay? And if you guys want more in depth when it comes to credit restoration, business credit, access to funding, get with Cynthia. Cynthia, raise your hand, right? Cynthia and Lucy and myself, we'll all help you. Okay? Another thing we incorporated, my partner here, Sesmas, how many of you guys know people who need to pay taxes or do their taxes? Are we in tax season, right? How many of you guys want the most write-offs and the most money coming back to you, right? There's also brochures on the table where if you get with SESMA, she'll basically set an appointment with you at no charge, and she'll show you how to maximize all the different ways to get the most amount of taxes back to you. How many of you guys like that?
Yeah.
Right? So with that, as you know, I can go forever because I'm excited about what I do, and I'm excited at my life today. How many of you guys are excited? You like to say aye.
Aye.
God, that didn't seem like excited. If you guys got $1 million in your pocket, how many of you guys would be excited?
Aye.
Aye. There we go. How many of you guys are excited today? You got way up today. Say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Once again, my name is Marlon McKinney. Thank you so much.
Thank you. How many people in here would like $1 million?
There you go. All
right.
Okay, this is just a little advertising, but you'll find on there that there's a little phone number at the bottom. Look at the bottom there. That if you want to do advertising like that, you can get a hold of the company and you can get your own password. Okay? That's great. I love to give it away for tips. People get real excited until they see no tip.
Yeah.
So we have Rich. Is it Gocher or Gotcher?
Gocher.
We have Rich Gocher here. And he's going to talk to us about oil and gas royalty. Do you want to run that video first or do you want to talk a little bit first? Okay. So we've got that. Let's see here. That.
another avenue of making money. Probably all seen the oil wells going night and day as you drive down the freeway. And if you're a royalty holder, then you know you're just making money. The more they pump those oil products out of the ground, and now they're doing fracking and they're getting more oil than ever before. That all adds up. And the question is, though, how does this compare to maybe some of the real estate that you've already been familiar with? So I've got a little spreadsheet here. I don't know if you can help me find it, Dan.
Yeah, let me know if you can help there.
It's a little comparison about comparing your oil and gas royalties to your typical rental properties. So we have a company called Hill Country Royalty Partners, and we've partnered up with a company, an oil company, Richfield Oil, out in Texas, and they've been in business since 1916. So over 100 years in business, they know how to do the oil and gas business. So if you look at a few of the comparisons here, number one, if you're renting properties, of course you want to know who your tenant is, right? So they have about 100 years of picking the right tenants. But their tenants aren't just mom and pop trying to pay the bills, it's major oil companies like Exxon. So that's the kind of tenants that they have. They're very spot on paying their bills, and they always get their rental checks, their royalties, month by month. Second thing is your expenses. With a gas and oil royalty, you get all those expenses are paid. The cost of drilling, the cost of insurance, the cost of maintenance, you know, all of the things that go into the oil production, that's covered by the oil companies. So as an owner of the land leasing to the company, you just get your royalties and you get your land lease automatically. According to the other model, though, of course, landing or owning rental properties, have done that. And you know, when the garbage disposal breaks down, someone's got to fix it. So you got to pay for the plumber, pay for the roofer, pay for the electrician. All that adds up. It comes right out of your bottom line. So with your oil and gas royalties, that's on the oil company. They take care of it. Tax write-offs with your oil companies, there's something called depletion. And so since this is a limited, finite resource, the government, who writes the tax laws, apparently there's a lot of oil owners in the Senate because the tax laws are extremely favorable to the royalty owners. Initially, when they drill, they're going to get a lot more oil those first 1 to 5 years. So they can maximize their depletion. Might be 15, 25, 35, 40% depletion because they have extra production. So they're depleting that asset, and that's a great write-off. Similar in real estate, you have depreciation, but it's capped, and also when you sell, you have to give it back. So with the oil royalties, or the depletion credit, there's no recapture. And also, once you get to 100%, it just keeps on going. You can go 200%, 300%, it doesn't matter. You still get depletion every year for generations. Finding a deal, that's where we come in. We find the oil reserves. The company that's doing this out in Texas right now, they're with the Eagle Ford Shale, and it's hundreds of miles of land that's drilling. And they're doing about 17,000 wells right now, but historically it's predicted that they could do 170,000 wells in this area. It's the 8th largest oil find on Earth, as you know. So plenty of resources there. Finding this deal, though, is very rare because how are you going to jump in as a $100 million investor? Well, they have the right contacts and they know the right people. They've already been doing these contracts. So what we're doing right now is a $20 million raise. The minimum investment is $27,000, and the maximum is $20 million. So once that's full, then we'll go on to the next one. The returns are very favorable, between 5 to 15% per annum. And so it's average about 10% per year. And once you recoup your investment, it just keeps on paying. That's why the Texas oil kids are driving the Corvettes and the Hummers to high school, right? Debt, there's no debt. This is just a cash raise. So therefore, it's different from your typical real estate investment where you have some mortgage. You know, you got to get your monthly mortgage that comes every month, whether you have a tenant or not. But with the oil, you make the one-time investment, and then you get the royalty check every month on the 15th, like clockwork. Number six, minimum investment. We already went through that. $27,000 right now, and you can do this as many times as you want. And it's generational. You can pass it on through your 401k or your IRA, your family trust, and what have you. So what I have a little sign-up sheet. If you are interested, just put your name and number. I'll contact you. And here's the